18.
When did you start serving?
5.
What's your favorite hobby?
Volleyball.
What do you do when you're not serving?
Homework.
In 1990 to me was all about that summer. I turned pro. I didn't have a sponsor. I was like in between. I was sort of negotiating, seeing who I was going to surf for and stuff. And then I was talking really heavily with Gotcha, who was really, Gotcha was the team at the time. You know, they had Potts and Shane Horan, Derek Ho, and just Rock Little, and just sort of had the craziest team at the time. I wanted to surf for Quicksilver, but it didn't seem like they were in the picture. I went on a trip to Mexico, and my then manager said, when you get back, I'll know who you're going to surf for, and I'll have this thing figured out for you. Don't even worry about it. Just go surf, and when you come back, we'll figure it out. We'll have an answer. And I came back, and he's like, it's going to be Quicksilver, and I'm so stoked. I was so caught off guard. Originally, it was supposed to be like a 5-minute piece we were going to do. It was just going to be a quick little film we were going to throw out there and just be like a marketing thing for Quicksilver. We got some good footage in the summer, and then when I won that Trestles contest, it kind of, you know, they started to talk like, you know, let's make this kind of a bigger thing. Let's work on it for a few months. And I was like, wow, that's pretty cool making a whole movie about myself. I was pretty blown away. Routine at Woolies was, well, we basically would surf all day, and then we'd come home and go to sleep, and I would try to find a place on the floor in between the cat diarrhea and throw up. He had these gnarly carpets, dude. He never cleaned them, and it was so gnarly. He had a cat who never left his room, and the thing was, like, had been sick and had literally, like, diarrheaed all over the floor, and it was left so long, it was like a hard crust. And it was just disgusting. But it was left so long it didn't smell anymore. It was heavy.
Hey, bro.
Ooh.
Time to go to the contest.
Dude, it's
the morning. It's the morning,
yeah, morning
of the final.
I'm tired. The morning of the final?
Time to get up.
No, it's the morning of the quarterfinals.
Are you ready to rock and roll?
Yes.
Basically, the last day of every contest, somebody does that to me still to this day. Like, it's the morning of the final. And usually it is the morning of the quarterfinal, so I say that. He just kind of came up with this list of questions. I think it was meant to be kind of stupid and childish and kind of funny. And, you know, like you're sitting down to make a movie on this guy, trying to be introspective, and we'll just ask the silliest questions we possibly can. You know, probably one of the most common things I've had people come up to me and say over the years is, you know, what's in that bowl? You know, and I'm like, a cereal. Do you like it?
What are you eating?
Cereal.
Do you like it?
Of course. Why would I eat it?
It's surprised over the years how many of those became like little sayings from people who like the movie.
What do you say? No wetsuits?
No wetsuits.
Wear some
trunks.
My star trunks.
I could probably look back and say that was the best trip of my life because Tavaru has become like a family and a second home to me, and I just love this place, and that was the beginning of it. It was November, so it was late, but we got one or two good swells that week, and each day it got like 2 foot bigger until it was like 10 feet one day, and we had great restaurants, and we had big cloud break. The same day that Cloud Break was good, restaurants was good. Boothie and Wooly and those guys went to Cloud Break with Dan Merkel. But they were in here eating breakfast, and restaurants was like the best waves I've ever seen in my life. So I just, you know, ran out there and started surfing. The boat came by, and they were like, you want to go to Cloud Break? And I'm like, I'm surfing the best waves I've ever seen right now. I'm staying here. Like, it can't be any better out there. There's no way. And even though we knew it was way bigger out there, but it was like 4 foot, 6 foot in here, maybe 4 or 5 foot, and it was just perfect waves. And there was only like four or five of us in the water. So I'm just going, there's no way I'm going out there. We're out there later or something. It was really sunny and beautiful and like no wind. And Dan Merkel was all pissed off that I didn't go out there and shoot. The afternoon we went back out there and the wind had come up. Swell was still just macking. Like it was, I was pretty scared because I didn't know the reef or anything. But I remember seeing Wooly get about a 10-footer and get a huge barrel on the thing. But the clouds had come over, so Merkel didn't want to shoot because it was cloudy now. And so about a month later, we get to Hawaii, and I just start hearing, like, Brock Little comes up to me and goes, what happened? Dan Merkel told me you completely pussed out in Fiji, and you wouldn't paddle out, and you were too scared. And he said you'll never amount to anything. I was like, fuck. That sucks. And so it became, like, that winter became my thing. It was, like, I had this, like, personal thing where, like, I wanted to prove Merkel wrong, you know? So I'm like, fuck it, I'm just going to charge and get some big waves and shut him up, you know?
He's damn good already, and if he can do what he does everywhere else in the world, he can do that here in Hawaii. He'll be the best surfer in the world, I reckon, for a long time. Unless he gets AIDS, he's just saving the girls after him.
When I got to Hawaii, that was kind of my mission, was like I wanted to surf big pipe, and I had paddled out at Waimea the year before my first time. You know, I wanted to surf big sunset and big Haleiwa and all that stuff. So that was the winter I really fell in love with pipeline and got familiar with it. I mean, I know the movie's about me, but I felt like a fly on the wall in some way because it was really Willie's project and he kind of ran with it and it was all his direction with music and filming and everything. I'm pretty sure the first time I saw the film was like, okay, we made it, come see it tonight. And it was in Orlando. Two of my best friends, they drove there with me and I remember just flying, like going like 100 miles an hour on the beeline to get out there. I was so excited. And I was stoked. I was like really nervous. I remember the first time watching it, I was so nervous. Hoping people would like it, you know.
Do you read the Wall Street Journal?
Every day.
Thank you.
Bye.
How was that?